REST API integration with Flutter. In this video, you will learn from scratch how to integrate RESTful API inside your Flutter application, starting from JSON to model conversion, HTTP API calls, and then populating that data on the interface. In 2020, I did my first live stream where I taught RESTful API integration, and it was one of its kind. But apparently, it got a very good user response. And over the time, Flutter platform kept on changing, the null safety came, and a lot of things was hard to follow up. So today, I'm redoing this tutorial with latest version of Flutter and null safety in place. So what are we waiting for? Let's start with the Visual Studio Code. Let's create all the folders that we need. First of all, we will need models folder, then services, and the views folder. Inside views, I'm going to create homepage.dart, which is going to be our main page. And while I'm creating a basic template, you can see I use a lot of shortcuts like tab in betweens or STF or STL to generate a stateful and stateless widget. So the point is you should be using smart way to generate the code, not the hard way. Alright, so I have the page ready with the title post. Okay, I'm going to link this from the main file. So instead of saying my homepage, I'll be calling homepage, which doesn't have any parameter. And let's go ahead and resolve this. Perfect. Now our actual work will begin, where we want to fetch all the posts and show on this screen. So let's go ahead and check out the API which we are going to use in today's tutorial. So we'll be using JSON placeholder. I'll put link in the description so you can try yourself. And basically it gives dummy data for all these kind of APIs. And today we're going to use the post API. So you can think of it as like a Facebook post or any social media post. So the first thing we have to do is select all the JSON data and paste inside app.quicktype. Now you may define a name of your class. So I'm going to say post here, and it has automatically generated all the model file for you, and it has done all the conversion of JSON to string and conversion to the list. So just copy this JSON file. Okay, copy this dart and create a file inside models. So I will call post.dart and paste whatever you have copied. Now this is the place where null safety comes into the picture. You have to explicitly specify each property. Either it's required, like it will have the data, or it's optional, then you have to place a question mark in front of the property. So user ID, ID, title, I know that it's gonna be there with my post, but the body may be, you know, optional kind of thing. So this is what you have to observe for your model, right? You can place question mark for all of them or make required all of them, right? So far we have learned how to create model from our JSON response. Now let's go ahead and use this data inside our page. So what we are expecting is list of posts, right? We don't want to display just one post. We want a list of posts. Okay. And for that, I'm going to create one flag, which will keep a track whether the API response has loaded or not. So I'll just create a variable is loaded, and initially it will be false. So let's go ahead and implement the body part of our page, and I'm going to use a list view dot builder here. And if you're a beginner and you want to understand the list view widget first, you can click on the card over here. All right. So inside our item builder, I'm going to return one widget, and as of now, let's say container. Okay. And then maybe I will write one child as a text. And for time being, let me just say hi. Okay, so at this point, we should be having infinity number of hi, right? Because we didn't specify the count of this list. So you can define item count, and let's say 10 as of now. Okay, all of these values, I'm going to make it dynamic. So don't worry about that. Now you will see 10 hi's. Okay, now it is time to fetch the actual data and replace this boring hi. Okay, so I'm going to override the init method. Now the reason, because I want to load the data when the page initializes. I don't want to repeat it on every build. And if you're using state management, if you're using controller, probably this part of code should be written inside that controller. Okay, but we are not going to use any controller. I don't want to complicate this video. Let's make it simple. So what I have done here, I have created one method which is responsible to get the data, and that method I'm calling on init. Okay, so here I want to make it asynchronous so that I can fetch the data and wait for that response. Now what I will do, once the response comes, I will assign it to the post, but we don't have any helper which can fetch the data from internet. So let's go ahead and implement that. To make a remote call, I'm going to create one file inside services and I will name it remote services. You can name whatever you feel like, okay? And this is nothing but a simple class which is responsible of fetching data from internet. So it is not something fancy, it doesn't derive from anything, it's just a separation of code, okay? So what I want to do here, I want to fetch some data, and of course it's gonna come later in the future, so the return type will be future of list of post. Make sense? And I will name it as get post. Let me quickly fix the issues in this method and we are good to start with the HTTP implementation. Now to make HTTP call, we need one library and that I'm going to install with the help of terminal. So let's go ahead and write few commands inside terminal. I have added link to this command and the package itself in the description section below. Alright, so once the package is added, we're gonna import the reference to HTTP library. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. Now using this HTTP alias, I'm going to create a client object. It is recommended in a bigger projects to create HTTP client instance so that you don't open port again and again. Now this is something, you know, you will understand on the later stage in a bigger projects what does it really mean, but as of now we have the client object and I'm going to parse the URL, which is this JSON URL from where we are getting all the post. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this and paste inside here. It will parse the URL and give you the URI or URL, whatever you call it. And then using the client object, I'm going to call a get request. So we write it like this, response is equal to client.get, and then you specify your URL, which is our parsed URI. If you want to specify headers, in case you have it, you can do that right here. Now, once you get the response, it is very important that you check whether the response was success or not. And the success code is 200. If you want to know more about different success code, you can click on this card above here. And now we know that our response is successful because it's 200. I'm going to get the body part of the response, okay, which is actual JSON string. And this JSON we will pass to the method which we generated from app.quicktype. So here I will say post from JSON. Now this method comes from the generated model and then you just have to pass the JSON and it will give you the list of post which we want to return from this method. Simple, right? So let's glue all together. I'm going to call this method from our home page. Remember, we left on the get data. So I will say remote service. Okay, I'm creating one object of remote service and calling get post and it will give you the list of post, right? Don't forget to use await keyword because then you will get something else like a future or something. Okay, forget about that. So what you have to do here, you have to make a check that you receive some valid post. And if it is so, then make is loaded true so that your user interface can update accordingly. Alright, so let's move to the UI part. Here, first thing we have to do is based on this post, we will change the count. Instead of 10, I will say posts.length. Now, this post can be null, so we have to do a null check here. And then you should have as many as elements as your post length. Still, the text says hi. We're gonna change it later on. But first thing we're gonna do is change this list view visibility based on is loaded or not. So if it is loaded, then we will show the list view, of course. And if it is not loaded, so we will show a replacement widget, which will just show a circular progress bar. Or if you want to go fancy, you can add a shimmer effect or something like that. Let's restart the application and see what we have. You're going to see the circular progress bar. And once it is done loading, you're going to see the list of highs. At this point, we are done with the API integration. Now quickly, I'll be modifying the layout to show all the post content. So if you want to leave, give it a thumbs up. But if you want to follow along, you're most welcome to do so. Basically, I'll be using text widget, all the properties of it like styling, max line, overflow. And also I will show you one of the situation where we'll get a layout overflow and how to tackle that. So basically, I just duplicated this text widget to show the body content, and you will notice that I've handled the null situation because inside our model, we said that body can be null. And you will see some cross alignment to start so that everything starts from the beginning. Then I'll be wrapping this widget with another widget, and that one will go in another widget, and that's how Flutter works. You have the nested widget, you keep on modifying the properties, the decoration, the radius and everything, and you have a beautiful UI ready in a minute. Only you have to care about some of the widget which doesn't have their own size. It grows and shrinks based on their children. So it doesn't really know how much size they want. It just expands itself or shrinks. So in that situation, you have to explicitly define or wrap it inside another widget, which will tell that expand this widget or make it flexible and shrink it, right? And with all of those easy code, you have the beautiful Flutter application with REST API integrated. Well, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you people learned something. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe the channel if you haven't already. If you want to learn more about Flutter, you can go ahead and check these two videos right here. I will see you guys in the next one.